everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. So it has been a minute, but today we are going to dive into Billie Eilish's new album, Hit Me Hard and Soft. I can't lie, I've got pretty high expectations for this album because her previous album, Happier Than Ever, is probably one of the best albums of all time. But with all that said, I just want to get on with the video. So do give this video a thumbs up if you do enjoy. Subscribe down below if you haven't already and want to see more reactions like this. So the first track is called Skinny. Oh, these vocals are coming through. This is beautiful. God, that is so cool how she added the sound of a crowd. There's already so much that I could say about this. Billie knows how to start an album. This song has some links to getting older, with the lyrics like, am I acting my age now? Am I already on the way out? But particularly as someone who is so high up in the public eye, like Billie is, there's always that fear that you're not going to be relevant anymore, and sort of that pressure to always be on your best game. What a lyric! And the internet is hungry for the meanest kind of funny. Like, that is just so true. And somebody's got to feed it. Oh, wow. We've still got so much of this song left. We've literally still got a minute of this song left, but there isn't any more lyrics. I was about to say, I don't think I've ever heard Billie sound that good. And I know that Billie's got a lot of hate in the past, where people have said, like, she whispers or something along the lines of that, but I'm sorry. She's never sounded this good. And if this doesn't prove a point and make those people think anything different, then the fact that she's saying things like, I cry, I know that is so simple of a lyric, but I feel like this is just so vulnerable and such like a raw way to start this album. Whoa. The way that that song just went into the next song kind of gave me a bit of a jump scare. Why does this sound different for Billie? Is it just me, or does this sound different? Anyway, let's just digest the lyrics a second. I could eat that girl for lunch. Okay, it's a craving, not a crush. Okay, wow, well, that is different. Very different for Billie. I think Billie has recently came out as bisexual, so I guess that is what she's talking about, I guess, exploring her sexuality. That's all I've really got to say about that one. It's a bop, it's a dancey one. It's probably not my sort of thing.
said before, I can't cope with anymore.
She just sounds better and better. What I was gonna say was, one thing that I love about Billie's music is her songs usually don't just stay in one kind of music sound. Most of her songs go through different kinds of sounds. Like, we go on a journey throughout Billie's music. The next song is called Birds of a Feather. In the grave. I feel like this sounds very different for Billie as well. I feel like this album is quite experimental. I mean, that's what I'm getting so far. That is so cute! Wow, this is so cute. I honestly don't have much more to say than that. I feel like so far every song has been so different. I love it. And this one, honestly, I don't know if this is too early to say, but this one might be one of my favourite Billie songs.
And time breaks your heart. She was your girl. You showed her the world. She was crying on my shoulder. All I could do is hold her until July. You don't need to remind me. I should put it all behind me, shouldn't I? But I see.
Oh my god. What's happening? We've still got some lyrics. I can't remember, maybe I'm making this up, but I'm pretty sure in a previous song she mentions Valentine's Day. This song is beautiful. I honestly don't have much more to say than that. The vocals are insane. I feel like as we're going through this album, each song just keeps getting better and better. I don't think there's another word for this song other than perfect. I feel like this whole song tells its own story. The first lyric is, "Things fall apart and time breaks your heart," which I feel like is a big theme throughout this song. Things falling apart, other things falling into place. I guess it's kind of like a story of being there for someone going through a breakup. At the start, this song kind of gave me similar vibes to Heartbreak Girl by 5 Seconds of Summer. So I guess what I'm getting, at least from this song, is Billie's talking about being there for someone who is going through a breakup, but really she likes this person. I think that out of all of the sounds and sort of genres that Billie dives into, my favourite one is where it's just like this, where it's more stripped back, vulnerable. Not to say that I don't appreciate the other kind of songs, but this is my favourite type of Billie, I suppose. And again, this goes back to the point I was saying about we go on a journey throughout Billie's music. We start really stripped back. Throughout the song, she does stuff like what she's just done there with vocals and production changes, and it kind of just, you're not expecting that kind of progression. And then we go back down. You could have been the greatest. I wish you the best for the rest of your life. Felt sorry for you when I looked in your eyes. Is it me or does she sound different? Like her voice sounds different? But I need to confess, I told you all alone. Whoa, she's telling us a story here. She says, you said you'd never fall in love again because of me, then moved on immediately. But when she says immediately, she laughs as she's saying it. What I was gonna say was, I feel like this song kind of follows the story of the previous song. The title of the song is L'amour de ma vie, which I'm assuming means the love of my life in French. That is kind of, in a sense, a parallel to Taylor Swift's LOML, because when she first released that track list, I'm pretty sure everyone just thought, that means love of my life. And it didn't, it meant loss of my life. What is going on? I don't know how I feel about this. What is going on? Whoa. Am I going delusional, or is this like a proper story? Because in a previous song, I think was it Wildflower? She said that someone was crying on her shoulder. And then in this song, she says, "Wanna know what I told her with her hand on my shoulder?" So are these songs like linked? Are we talking about the same person? So this is my theory, if anything. So maybe in that previous song, when Billy was there for someone who was going through a breakup, the reason why that person left that person was to go for Billy. But then that same person did the same thing to Billy. And that's what Billy is saying now, that she knew it was coming. This is probably the most Billy song, the most Billy sounding song on this album. Like, I feel like this song goes back to the early sort of Billy songs. We're going back to that theme of what was it that she said in like one of the first songs about she's something that I want to eat. In this song, she's saying, "I came in through the kitchen looking for something to eat." Whoa. Why am I getting stalker vibes? What I'm getting is we're just in love with this person and we're trying to do anything in our power to get them into our reality. I don't know why I'm saying ah, this is what Billy's doing. And if we go back to one of the first songs on this album, Lunch, she says, "I could eat that girl for lunch." And then in this song, we've got similar parallels, which I guess I should have guessed considering this song is called The Diner. Okay, next up we've got Bittersweet. Bittersweet, but it's spelt different. This is interesting. Previous song, L'amour de ma vie, she didn't actually say the title in French. She said the title, but in English. That is really interesting. I feel like all these songs follow a story. Why is this so intense? Wow. Honestly, I feel like there's so much I could say about that song. I don't really know where to start. I guess what she's saying is that she really wants to want this other person, but she can't develop those feelings. We went on a journey with that. Okay, well, we've actually come to the last song. Wow. I feel like we've only just started listening to this album. But the last song is called Blue. Birds of a Feather. I'm just looking at these lyrics and there's so many different parallels to previous songs. She said open up the door in the previous song. In the back of my mind, I'm still overseas. Why is there literally a lyric from every song? I love this. Is she talking to her younger self? Wait, is that not a parallel to something she said at the first song? Wow. In the first track, Skinny, she says 21 took a lifetime. And then in the last track, she also references 21. What I'm getting from that last song is she's kind of reflecting on all the stuff that she's done and kind of reflecting on not only her life, but like her album. One of the last lines on the album is "It's over now." I think that just closes the album really nicely. Was "Hit Me Hard and Soft" by Billie Eilish. Oh my god, there is so much that I could say about this album. I can't really find a better word to describe this album other than perfect. And that's a big word, that's a statement. I feel like the title itself fits perfectly for this album. I feel like this album tells a story so beautifully. You can really see the evolution of Billie, the improvement of her vocals, of her songs, of her songwriting. Honestly, this album is a 10 out of 10. So as it stands, I would say that my favourite songs are Wildflower, Birds of a Feather, Skinny and Blue. That is it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. Bye.